I make the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Join us in our design movement.
Hi, very good afternoon to all of you. This is Harshit Desai from MIT ID Innovation Program. This is the fourth webinar that we are having as a part of the MIT ID webinar series, and essentially this edition will kind of help you understand the recent and the new program that we have started. It's a one-year PG program called MIT ID Innovation Program, and the focus of this program is kind of building on our capabilities of design thinking that we have been doing for past so many years. So we have come up with a new program which kind of combines design, engineering, management and liberal arts. So looking at the current trends in the industry and what's expected out of young graduates coming out of colleges, especially after their graduation, this is something which we found that would be a most relevant program for kind of young graduates coming from different diverse fields of design, technology, or for that matter, any other discipline which kind of relates itself with innovation. The program is a one-year program in which we have split it into two kind of major semesters, where first semester is focused on giving you taught inputs, where the different courses and different kind of modules, which kind of cover different topics spanning design, technology, business and humanities. And in the last 6 months of the program, you are supposed to take up a project, which is a live project with industry or something that you can generate of your own and would want to kind of work on it as your own idea. So this program will give you a opportunity to kind of take an idea and make it into a real world. And whatever is required to kind of have you the required skill sets and the required knowledge and the required exposure for making this happen is what the program covers. So I'll briefly take you through the modules which we currently have. And so we start with a 1 week immersion exercise where the entire batch, we kind of take them to a outdoor location, and that is a lot of team building and an induction program that happens off-site. We also take this week as an opportunity for the students to kind of visit places where there is real innovation happening and experience it firsthand, because when you see things in action by the people who have really done it themselves and kind of build something innovative in this space, that both serves as a good inspiration and also gives you a kind of a clear direction as to how innovation has happened in the past. So typically this would take students to different startups, to different bigger organizations which are innovation led, and also certain other individuals who have kind of done things passionately and driven in a driven way. So this 1 week exercise kind of helps the students to come together, get to know each other. Also the faculty who are going to be part of the program, they are also accompanying the students during the outbound training. So that also helps them to develop the whole teamwork for the rest of the program. Then we have a module called, it's a coined word and it's a kind of a unique approach towards innovation, and we have termed it as Dashless Dash. So Dashless Dash essentially takes the concept of how do I imagine new products, new services and new systems without its critical component. So this is a known method in innovation, but we have kind of expanded and also taken this opportunity to expose students to history of innovation, how things have worked in the past, what are the different thinking methods that somebody needs to understand innovation both as a cognitive area of work, as well as how do I kind of put it into practice. So that is the whole premise of the course called Dashless Dash. And it's a 3-week module which is discourse based. So there are a lot of discussions, a lot of inputs on different aspects which are peripheral to innovation. So we get a chance to study history, philosophy, sociology, and all the relevant aspects in which the innovation ecosystem eventually is created. Then there is an interesting module, and it's like it forms the crux of the program in a way, where the students are exposed to human-centered innovation. Human-centered design principles have been proven useful in so many contexts, and today's world requires solutions to be built not only which are technology focused, but where the human aspects are being taken care of. So this is a very intense 6-week bootcamp format module where young entrepreneurs, young designers, young innovators, they themselves have facilitated this course, and they have worked with the students in a hands-on practical way, where they are taken real life scenarios. They were out on the field for a major part of the program, and then they really come up with some insights on which they are kind of expected to propose solutions and also look at ways in which some scalable solutions can be made. So typically the course module doesn't end with it being just being a concept. So they have to go further and actually build a scalable business model around it, so that whatever solution is being proposed becomes as real and as practical as it can be. So this is, and through this course, they get exposed to different methods of design, different techniques of brainstorming, different techniques of prototyping, different techniques of kind of how do you put things together and make things work. So this is one of the most interesting modules that that we have as a part of the program. Next up comes uniquely designed module, which is what we have called as World 4.0. We all are aware of the terms called Industry 4.0 and Industry Automation and all of that. And again, it takes a lot of technology into account, where how technology is shaping the world, how technology has an impact on our all aspects, all walks of life, be it health, be it family, be it relations, be it work. There are so many aspects which are now impacted by technology, and it's very difficult in today's world to imagine things which will not be based on a technology. But again, as the whole program's philosophy and premise is that we are marrying it with the right inputs in design, humanities and business, where we look at not only technology forecasting, but also look at how the whole world will look like in new few decades. So it's a exercise in kind of trend forecasting and kind of building a future world, building scenarios, and then using that as an input to create new products and services, which will otherwise exist in future, but has an implication on today's business as well. Again, as a part of this module also, there is an interesting space that we have created on design fiction and speculative design. So these are two very interesting inputs which are interweaved into the World 4.0, because speculative design is a very comparatively new method which has not been yet explored. So what we have found that these methods typically take you away from the today's very here and now kind of a thinking, and then are kind of useful to develop something which is completely new and completely unseen. So World 4.0 is again happening in a very live format, where the students get to work on live projects. This is led by one of the leading trend forecasting and design research and consulting agency. And that's where the students are getting a chance to work on something which is live right there in the classroom. And the last module of the program, which is part of the taught input, is the Making with Digits. So when we say Making with Digits, the entire focus is on making and prototyping and making things work. So the students get exposed to different techniques, different technologies, there are different labs and workshops which are available on the campus for them to experiment, tinker, and kind of convert whatever ideas that they have worked on into a tangible solution. And they are free to explore the kind of products or kind of solutions they would come up with. And within a given time, they have to create something which is working. And that is the whole focus of the course called Making with Digits. So this modules that we just kind of spoke about, they have a good mix of the four pillars of the program, which I mentioned as design, technology, business, and humanities. So once the students get exposed to all these inputs in a very holistic way, this prepares them to take up either a live project which is given by the industry or define something which they are passionate about. So these are the two tracks which the students get to choose based on what and where they are coming from and what is their eventual aspiration and the career goals. So depending on what the students choose, they will get an opportunity to work either on a live project with a industry or with an organization who is supporting the program, or they take up something of their own where again there will be mentors, there will be other resources which are provided for them to get the idea to reality phase. So yeah, this is the gist of the program structure, and the program structure is something which is very unique about this 1 year program. It's unmatched, at least in India. Globally there are few programs where it can be benchmarked, but in India to have a 1 year program which is so rigorous and which is packed with these very, very industry relevant inputs, it's hard to find. And another advantage of doing this program in this format is all the facilitators and all the faculty members who are coming as a part of the faculty team, they all are practicing professionals. So they either come from the field of design or technology, or they themselves are innovator and they have a proven body of work, which is what the students get exposed to. And that is where there is a lot of live component to the entire training, even if it is a classroom component. In between the modules, there are also opportunities for the students to visit different places, either for their own research or for validating whatever the solutions that are being built, or kind of understand the context in a better way. So these are immersions which can happen at different places at different times for students depending on what projects they have chosen. But this is also a component which is very, very critical, because all that whatever is being learnt, immersion gives them a chance to validate and implement certain things and test whatever solutions are being built. So yeah, this is an overview of the program. And are there, yeah, are there any questions? How does it? Okay. Yeah, so we have this question from Julie, and she is asking that can we do this program online? So it's very difficult to pack in this kind of rigor, because the program entirely is based on something that you continuously do in a very hands-on way with the faculty team and with the other kind of mentors that are around you. So this entire thing will not be able to replicate in an online model. So as of now, the whole program is a 1 year residential full-time program, and online is not the right medium for such a kind of a program. That's how I would like to answer this. Eventually, we have some plans to have some shorter programs or some shorter modules, especially for working professionals who will not be able to, say, dedicate a whole year's time for this program. There are some offerings or there are some modules which are being rolled out in a online model, but that's for later. So as of now, it's a 1 year full-time residential program. Regarding the industry placements, one part was that obviously most of the inputs to the students are given by people who come from the industry. So as a part of the program itself, a lot of dialogue and networking happening for the students and for the industry, because they get to see firsthand as to what are the skill sets, what are the interests of the students, what are their capabilities, and if there is a fit in the students' interest and skill set vis-a-vis whatever the role the industry wants to offer. So this will naturally lead to some industry collaboration and eventually to the internships and to the placements. And apart from that, MIT ID as an institute has been running for past 13, 14 years now. And we have a wide network of industry partners who we have been working very closely. And fortunately, with this program, the response has been very, very buoyant. They are all very positive about the core structure and the way it is shaping. And there are already discussions which have underway where there are chances and opportunities for the students to get into live industry projects and which will eventually lead to the placements. So yeah, and so as of now, there is only the first batch which is yet to graduate. So they are still in the process of approaching the industries and all of that. So there aren't any companies immediately for this. But yeah, in next 2-3 months, we'll have the real numbers and figures where there will be kind of indication of what kind of placement the students have got. Neeraj Nikam has a question which says, what will be the opportunities for me after completion of this program? So yeah, I kind of covered it in the previous question. So in terms of opportunities, one is getting a job in the industry is one of the destinations. Having your own venture where you come up with something and you develop your own product or a service and then convert that into a venture is one of the routes. Third route, which also opens up, is that if somebody gets into innovation consulting, so for example, work on projects or help other people achieve their innovation goals, because of the training that the students have got, they understand innovation in a conceptual way also, and also there are hands-on activities and hands-on projects which they have done, which kind of makes them capable to handle other innovation projects where they can act as mentors or consultants and work together with teams whoever wants to achieve some innovation goals. So yeah, these are three broad roles as of now based on how the program is currently structured. Yeah, so I think there are a few questions which are related to the selection process. So currently what we follow is admissions which is on a cycle basis. So every month the admission application window opens and the students have to kind of fill up an online form. So all those details are available on the website. But as a process, we follow a 3-stage process. So the first step after you fill up a form is when you have to appear for a video interview. So the first stage is a video interview where we are able to understand your motivation, why did you apply, your background, and also your general communication skills is what a quick video interview gives us. The second round is a SOP round where you are supposed to submit answers and detailed responses to certain questions in an essay format. So this is something which again happens in an online way where we send you the questions, you have to fill up those questions, submit those answers in a stipulated time, and after you clear these 2 rounds, then you are called for a personal interview to the campus. Again, there is a panel of faculty which will interview you, and there is a test which is given to you to understand your whatever skills you come on board with based on your background and based on your experience. And a cumulative score of these 3 rounds is what determines whether you are selected or not selected. But the entire process would it would take around 30 to 45 days, and that's one of the cycles. So currently there is a admission cycle which is open, and the moment you apply, you'll be able to get the further details based on your application details. Yeah, again there is a question on startups and entrepreneurship. So see, this program gives you an opportunity to actually come with an idea that you already have in mind, and the entire 1 year can be dedicated to refining that idea further, getting more inputs, testing it, making it more market friendly or market ready with inputs of different mentors and people. So the courses which I mentioned, which are the taught courses, they all can be applied on your own venture idea. So that's the first part of the support that the program offers, is refining the business idea and kind of helping you fine tune where you start from. So this is where the support for the venture starts while you are still in the program. The 6-month project that we mentioned is also an opportunity for you to actually implement whatever idea you have and build the right solution. So by the time you complete the program, you are already kind of ready with a pilot or a prototype which is ready and which needs some more refinement, but you get to know the direction. After the program, there are different schemes or different funding sources which we are connected with, and depending on what is the product proposition or whatever is the idea, we will connect you to the right people, both in terms of any technical support required or any other assistance required, and the entire guidance on entrepreneurship and venture creation. So most of the facilities and mentors are available on the campus itself here, and you get access to them through the program and after the program. And beyond that, there are some tie-ups that we are already getting into, where anything specialized will be able to kind of made available to you from that point of view. Scholarships, in a way, so what we are trying to develop as a funding model is provide more time for the students to pay back their fees. So it's a new concept in India, and it's called income share agreement. In this, you get to choose the payback period. So in a way, when you take a funding assistance from a bank in the form of a loan, there is an immediate requirement of paying it back as per some terms and conditions. So here the scholarships are kind of given in the format of you deferring the payment period. And then it also comes with its own benefits of the flexibility and the timing that you get to choose and the amount that you will be able to pay back after you start earning. So some eligible students who come with the right merit and the right need may get a deferment in the payment by saying that they may not have to pay the tuition fee upfront, some percentage of the tuition fee upfront, but they can pay it later when they complete the program and when they start earning. So yeah, I mean, in terms of scholarships, there are no formal scholarships available as such, like the way you would find it in other courses or other universities. But this is a very unique model where it is directly connected with your success. So you pay back only when you start earning. And that's how we are trying to build the whole funding mechanism, in the form of supporting whoever is a needy student and whoever is the right candidate to pursue this program. So affordability and accessibility is something which we are taking care of through the income sharing agreement as a model.
I make the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.